you can create course group sets and apply them to graded content, such as group discussions and assessments. Let's take a look. You start the course group's creation process on the course content page. The first time you create a course group, select Create and Manage Groups in the Details and Action section under Course Groups, and the Create Group Set page opens. On the Create Group Set page, provide a descriptive title and select how you want to divide your students among groups. If you select Custom, you can create as many groups as you want, with any number of students in each group. Select the students you want to add to your first group. Then, open the menu next to one of their names and select Create a New Group. Edit the group name and add a group description if you want. Repeat this process for your remaining students. If you select Randomly Assign, students are randomly assigned to the number of groups you choose. In the Number of Groups menu, select how many groups you want to create. Students are equally assigned to the number of groups you choose. Again, you have the option to edit the group name and add a group description. And finally, you can ask students to self-enroll in groups. When using self-enrollment, you have the option to add the enrollment start and end date and set a maximum number of members per group. If you set an enrollment period, when the enrollment period ends, the system automatically enrolls the unassigned students. You also have the option to add additional groups, edit the group names, and add group descriptions. When you ask students to self-enroll in groups, they receive a course announcement and an activity stream notification about the groups they need to join. After you create your course groups, you can begin using them when creating group discussions and assessments. Please note, membership changes you make in a group set affect the content level items where the groups are used, such as in group discussions and assessments.